Firstly, I'd like to welcome the High Sheriff for County Down, Mr. James Smith, to our local dignitaries, the clergy, Cumber Brass, Mr. Phil Neal, the Piper, Keith Burnside, and you, the people of Cumber. Thank you for joining us this morning in this act of remembrance. The service will now begin.
It is with great honour and prayerfulness that we gather today in the midst of conflict on so many frontiers in our fragile world. We assemble to remember those who gave their lives in order to create a new world of peace, reconciliation and good relations that in themselves bring hope for future generations. Today, we are all part of that living story whose foundations are so clearly marked. We call to mind, we remember, we now pray together, entrusting those who have gone before us into the hands of our loving God, into the safe harbour of his love.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, we have assembled together in this place and at this time to pay solemn and due respect to the memories of those who have gone before, those who in and through their lives made the supreme and ultimate sacrifice. They laid down their lives for love of their fellow man. Today, in this garden of remembrance, we remember the fallen of two world wars and of subsequent conflicts. The British Mandate in Palestine, the Korean War, the Cyprus Emergency, the Aden Emergency, the Malayan Emergency, the Falklands, Afghanistan, the conflict in the former Yugoslavia, and here in our own province, in the turbulent decades known to us as the Troubles. Almighty God, remind us that the freedoms which we enjoy and which we so often take for granted were won, secured, and achieved for us by the bravery, heroism, and noble self-sacrifice of ordinary human beings, men and women who, through their training and their sense of service to Crown and country, gave of themselves with no thought of personal reward or personal gain. They enlisted not because of the love of war and conflict, but in an acknowledgement of the need to ensure that right was prevailed upon and that peace ultimately preserved, that wrong would not go unchallenged, and through their part, that wrong would be vanquished, that men, women, and children might live in peace. We are painfully aware that global conflict has not ceased. The continuing conflict in Ukraine, with millions displaced from their homes, destined to live their lives as refugees, countless thousands killed, and tens of thousands injured. An international community which struggles to find a solution and a resolution. We also bring to mind the unresolved issues in Afghanistan, Iraq, Iran, and in the Middle East. In the midst of these continuing and at times seemingly unresolvable conflicts, let us not lose faith. The faith that your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, the Prince of Peace, spoke of in his life, of the majesty and power of his loving and eternal Heavenly Father. Almighty God, hear our prayers this Remembrance Sunday for peace in our land and in the world. May our faith, our prayers, and the conduct of our lives be the means by which hatred and enmity shall cease, and thine eternal peace achieved, preserved, and maintained. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. And now, let us join together in the words which Jesus taught his disciples, as together we pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
scripture reading this morning is taken from Hebrews chapter 5, reading verses 1 to 10. Let us listen to God's word. For every high priest chosen from among men is appointed to act on behalf of men in relation to God, to offer gifts and sacrifices for sins. He can deal gently with the ignorant and wayward, since he himself is beset with weakness. Because of this, he is obligated to offer sacrifice for his own sins, just as he does for those of the people. And no one takes this honor for himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. So also Christ did not exalt himself to be made a high priest, but was appointed by him who said to him, "You are my son, today I have begotten you." As he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek." In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to him who was able to save him from death, and he was heard because of his reverence. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation to all who obey him, being designated by God a high priest after the order of Melchizedek. Amen.
If I may, in our reflection this morning, to go back 100 years beyond the Great War to the iconic era of conflict that Rollo Gillespie participated in, and more particularly to the climactic battle of that era of conflict, namely the Battle of Waterloo. In the words of the Duke of Wellington, the Battle of Waterloo was the closest run thing you ever saw in your life, and thus there were any number of moments on that fateful day that could rightly be described as turning points. But in the Duke's own assessment, none more so than the closing of the gates at Hougoumont, big old farmhouse, Hougoumont was a naturally well defensible position, and the Duke had some of his best men garrisoned there. Right throughout the battle, the French committed increasing numbers of resources to trying to seize the farmhouse, and the whole day long they were successfully repelled. The closest they came was when some of their troops made it into the courtyard, and certain British soldiers, led, if I'm not mistaken, by a battle-hardened Ulsterman, had the presence of mind and the courage to quickly close the gate before they engaged the French troops, thus ensuring that those Frenchmen would receive no reinforcements. And Wellington afterwards quite emphatically identified that as the decisive moment in that extraordinary conflict. Among those who closed the gates at Hougoumont, there was a young lad of about 18. He made it safely through the rest of the battle, and he made it safely back to Britain, where, by the standards of the 19th century, he lived to be a relatively old man. It's said that his home was always drafty, and as a result, successive generations of women in his family complained that he'd closed the door on Napoleon at Hougoumont, and he'd never closed the door since. Why tell that story this morning? Well, it has warmth and humanity, doesn't it? It has even perhaps a touch of humour. But it also illustrates the fact that whether it was back in the days of Rollo Gillespie and the Duke of Wellington, whether it was in the two world wars, whether it was here in our own province, or even indeed right to this present day in Ukraine or anywhere else, when somebody goes off to serve in armed conflict, there is a lasting legacy for them, for their families, and for their community. There can be positive elements of that for sure, as there was for that young man and his family, the grateful remembrance of heroic deeds carried out in a worthwhile cause. And that, of course, is a central element of what we're about this morning. But there are other things, of course, that are not nearly so happy about it. Other things that are desperately, desperately sad. Other things that are altogether heartbreaking, in a way, in truth, that somebody like me, who hasn't experienced it firsthand, can't really understand. I'm sure there's some of us standing here today who perhaps have been injured in some of the things that have been referred to, or maybe have lost family members or dear, dear friends. Do I have any idea what you're going through? Emphatically not. But Jesus does, and Jesus cares. We can't explore Hebrews chapter 5, verses 1 to 10 in anything approaching detail in this context today. But the thing that is repeatedly reiterated is the humanity of Jesus Christ. He was and is and always will be truly God. But he took upon himself true humanity when he entered this world, as we'll be thinking particularly of the Christmas season in a couple of weeks' time. And what that means is that Jesus knows firsthand what it is to be human. He knows firsthand what it is to suffer as a human being. He knows firsthand what it is to lose a loved one, and he knows firsthand what it is to be nailed to a cross. Jesus knows what is in your heart today. Jesus knows the things that stir grateful remembrance. And Jesus knows the things that cause agony and tears. And Jesus cares. Let's remember with gratitude heroic things that have been done in our name. Let's be honest about the agony and the heartache that we feel. And let's look to Jesus, because Jesus cares.
They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Start the reflame. His Majesty's High Sheriff for County Down, Mr. James Smith. The Mayor's representative on behalf of Ards and North Down Council, Councillor Trevor Cummings. I will now lay a wreath on behalf of Cumber Branch Royal British Legion. Thank you. the Royal Navy and the Royal Marines. Medical Corps. The regular army, the Royal Army Medical Corps. Battalion, the Royal Irish Regiment. Association of the Royal Irish Regiment Conspicuous Gallantry Cross. Regimental Association of the Ulster Defence Regiment, Conspicuous Gallantry Cross. Cumber Detachment Army Cadet Force. Royal Air Force Association. The Royal Ulster Constabulary George Cross Association. Thank you. Ulster Constabulary Widows Association. Of Northern Ireland. The Northern Ireland Fire and Rescue Service. Councillor Stephen Cooper on behalf of the TUV. Mr. Nick Matheson, MLA, on behalf of the Alliance Party. Councillor Philip Smith on behalf of the Unionist Party. Conservative and Unionist Party, Mr. Johnny Andrews. The Northern Ireland Prison Service. Visitation Roman Catholic Church. First Combat Scout Group. First Combat Girls Brigade. Second Combat Girls Brigade. On behalf of Mr. Stanley Martin, MID, Special Boat Service and L Detachment, Special Air Service. Mr. David Smith will lay a wreath on behalf of his relatives, Mr. David Smith, John Smith, and David John Smith. Rotary Club. Royal Black Institution. Royal Orange Lodge number 15. number 100. Funeral services. Cumber Regeneration Society. Cumber Masonic Order. Pesco. The Rangers Supporters Club of North Down. Be laid in memory of 2nd Lieutenant Edmund de Wind, Victoria Cross. Be laid on behalf of Mr. and Mrs. Tom McParland in memory of Lieutenant Colonel Blair Main, Special Air Service, DSO, and Three Bars. If there is anybody else who wishes to lay a wreath or to plant a poppy cross, would they please do so now?
God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the king, the commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord. And to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Concludes Cumber's Act of Remembrance. Thank you very much indeed for attending. We've had a great turnout this year and it is much appreciated. Thank you very much indeed and safe home.
Stand up, Paris. All up. Stand up.